Fathers play a very crucial role within the development of their child from birth up until adulthood. As a matter of fact, numerous studies recently have reached the conclusion that children with involved fathers have a social and academic advantage over children who are distant or have no relationships with their fathers. A researcher and a professor of pediatrics at the University of Maryland School of Medicine states that fathers who are involved with their children have children with fewer problems. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to tonight's episode as we rejoice and celebrate the birth anniversary of our beloved lady, Lady Fatima Al-Zahra. May peace and blessings be upon her. For this reason, I would like to send my congratulations to you, to everybody across the world, to all the Muslim communities, the Ahlul Bayt, the master of our time and our pious scholars on this very auspicious occasion. Now, Sayed Mudhafar Al-Qazwini is joining us tonight to discuss the life of this very important character within the religion of Islam and her relationship with her father, Prophet Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum, Sayyidina.
Alaykum assalam.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
It's good to see you once again.
Thank you.
It's good to be here. Sayyidina, can you please give us some background information about this lady and her father and what their relationship between the two?
Yes, as you mentioned, today's studies show that it is pivotal for a father to be in the life of his daughter and mm-hmm. how crucial that could be and how that can affect her future mm-hmm. and her entire life.
Definitely.
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi was there for his beloved daughter Fatima, peace be upon her, from the moment of her birth. Mm-hmm. And he was with her even the moments that he was taking his last breaths. Mm-hmm. And as we all know, he gave her glad tidings that she would be the first to join him. Today is a happy day, so mm-hmm. Let's talk about the birth of Fatima alayha afdal as-salatu was-salam and why today is such a blessed day mm-hmm. for all Muslims and why it was such a happy day for the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Well, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi married Khadija, the mother of all believers, peace be upon her. Shaykh al-Saduq says that all the women of Quraysh abandoned her. They stopped visiting her. Those who were her friends, her acquaintances, and they would visit her on daily basis when she married Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi as a mean of boycotting her. They stopped visiting her, they stopped speaking to her, and that was very difficult for the mother of believers, Khadija alayha mm-hmm. afdal as-salatu was-salam, for being, a lady that was powerful in her society, well-known in her society. Her voice was heard. All of a sudden, people abandoned her and boycott her. And that's when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent her a companion that used to speak to her from her womb.
Wow.
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi says, I would go into the house of Khadija, mm-hmm. peace be upon her, and I would hear my wife Khadija speaking to someone, laughing and having a good time mm-hmm. when I knew there was no one there. So I asked her, Khadija, what's going on? Who are you speaking with?
Yeah.
She told him, Ya Rasulullah, I am speaking to this infant, to this child that's in my womb, in my stomach. And Rasulullah, of course, had the knowledge, but this is for you and I to understand the situation of what our mother, the mother of believers, Khadija, was going through, and that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi describes to us what Fatima actually is and how she was made. She was conceived by her mother when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet to partake in 40 days in worship away from Khadija alayhi salam. For 40 days before you make this purified child, this purified daughter, you have to spend these 40 days in prayer, absolute supplication, absolute purity, nothing else. So when you go to your wife, there is no lust, there is no animalistic behavior. It's pure spirituality and nur and light, divine from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's after the 40 days Jibra'il alayhi salam came with the fruit from paradise and gave that fruit to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, told him to eat that fruit, and from that fruit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him his children. Rasulullah ate that fruit and went back after 40 days with so much joy that he could see his wife again, his love again. And with all of that, Fatima was made from a fruit from paradise. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi says, Fatima hawra'un insiya. She is an angel in a human shape, because her essence came from paradise.
Wow, beautiful.
Salamullah ala Fatima. That's how she was conceived. Then, in that same hadith by Shaykh al-Saduq, Shaykh al-Saduq says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, with all happiness, told Khadija, Ya Khadija, here's Jibra'il, the angel of God, giving me the best news ever, glad tidings that she will be a daughter at a time that people would bury their daughters, at a time where people would go give birth by a grave. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. The tafsir of this ayah is that the mothers of the people and the wives of the people of Quraysh would go sit on a grave. They would dig up a grave, sit on the grave, they would give birth by that grave. If it was a boy, they would keep it, and if it was a girl, they would throw it right into that grave.
Wow.
Right away. Or they would go and take their daughters that have turned 6, 7 years old and bury them alive.
Yeah.
While that child is asking her father or her mother, why are you burying me? Why are you putting me under the dirt?
Mm-hmm. Just to clarify this, this was pre-Islamic.
This was pre-Islamic, yeah. But Fatima alayhi salam was born in the first stages of the prophecy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. So from that moment where people were still bothered to have a daughter, Rasulullah says, this is glad tidings. I'm having a daughter. I'm very happy. This is a happy day. And through this daughter will come a'immatun hudat, the guardians and the imams and the guiders of mankind. And through her will come my children. It is through Fatima. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi was very happy and delighted. Mm-hmm. And he transferred that joy and delightment to the mother of believers, Khadija alayha afdalus salati wassalam. So days passed and the mother and daughter relationship grew. It was the most beautiful relationship, to a point that by the time that Khadija wanted to give birth, she did not care if the woman of Quraysh had boycotted her or not, because she had a person to give her joy every day. Her husband and her daughter, who was communicating with her from her womb. And the hadith continues that when Khadija alayha afdalus salati wassalam went into labor, none of the women of Bani Hashim nor the woman of Quraysh went to help her, because at that time there were no hospitals.
Yeah.
And people would give birth in their homes. So women from the city would go to the lady that's giving birth, mm-hmm. and they would take care of her while she gives birth or she's in labor.
Speaking of hospital, we do apologize for the noise in the background. It's an ambulance going. Hope everything is safe out there. But yes,
inshallah. And that's when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent four ladies. And what kind of ladies? The most noble of ladies.
Yeah.
To serve the mother of Fatima and this newborn, the daughter of Rasulullah, the beloved sweetheart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Maryam, peace be upon her, the mother of Jesus, the mother of Moses and the sister of Moses and the wife of Fir'aun. And they sat around Khadija, comforting her, holding her hand until she gave birth. She gave birth not alike other women. She was no different than the vicegerents or the prophets that were given birth to. Directly, she went into prostration, just like every single prophet when he was born, and every single imam that was born. And she gave her salam to every single one of them, and she raised her voice from that moment in the shahada of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the testimony of her father. So that's how Fatima, peace be upon her, was born. And Rasulullah was there from the first moment. And you know, even that first moment, if the father is not happy that he's having a daughter, this will affect the life
absolutely,
of that daughter.
Absolutely.
Rasulullah was joyous. He was happy that he's having a daughter. Even till today, within our communities, our societies, if a woman becomes pregnant and she tells her husband, I went and just did a, you know, a sunar and the child is a girl. Some men become grumpy. They become upset.
Yeah.
I wanted a boy. I wanted this. Till today, after 1400 years,
so
Rasulullah
present.
Became very happy and delighted.
Now, a couple of points that you mentioned that, you know, a lot were there, but a couple of points that I picked up from the hadith you mentioned is that through the birth of Fatima Zahra alayhi salam, she revolutionized the mentalities of the ignorant who were present pre-Islamic and who actually converted to Islam but still possessed that same mentality.
Yes.
So the action of Rasulullah, him accepting his newborn to be a child with joy, with happiness, revolutionized their mentalities. Another point is that you mentioned from day one, the support for that daughter is important, especially daughters are more sensitive than boys. Boys, you know, tend to be
as
fidgety.
As Amir al-Mu'mineen says, a woman is a rayhana.
Yeah.
وليست قهرمانة. She's
exactly.
not a wrestler or a boxer. She's something gentle.
Yeah.
And similar
fragile.
To a flower.
Yeah.
You know?
So basically what we understand is that supporting a child, specifically a girl, is more important, if you will, than supporting a man, because a man grows up to support himself from, you know, learning from his father. But recent studies, we see that a child grows up, a girl grows up learning from the men that are in her life from her early age. If her father was, you know, that oppressor to her mother, or was, you know, ill-tempered, ill-mannered, he gets angry very quickly, then she'll understand, she'll take a broader view of what men are like. So as a father, I don't have a daughter yet, but as a father to a daughter, what are the concerns that should be there for a daughter?
We learn from Ahlul Bayt and we learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. So hopefully today we could shed some light of how Rasulullah dealt with Fatima alayhi salam through the hadiths and the seerah of Rasulullah and his tradition. Fatima was the main concern of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Rasulullah's main concern weren't his wives, none of his wives. It was Fatima alayhi salam, to a point that every time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi would leave the city of Medina, the last person he would see was whom?
Fatima.
Fatima alayhi salam. He would go sit with her, comfort her, kiss her. And who was the first person he would go and visit as soon as he returned from his voyage or as soon as he returned to the city?
Who?
That was Fatima alayha afwala salatu wa salam. And this is a hadith accepted and a tradition accepted by both schools of thought and all schools of thought. Mm-hmm. Now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi used to visit Fatima alayha afwala salatu wa salam before anyone. And she would be the last person he would visit and the last face he would see before, for example, his troops mobilized and left the city to defend the Muslims and the Muslim body. It was Fatima alayha afdalu salatu wasalam, and he would show her the respect. She was his main concern. Every morning at the time of Fajr, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi would go stand at the house of Fatima. He would not go wake up his wives. He would not go stand by the doors of his wives. No, he would go stand at the door of Fatima alayha afdal as-salatu was-salam. Make sure that his family, his blood, his kin were awake and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was never disconnected.
Mm-hmm.
He raised her from an early age to be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She was his main concern. Every prayer, he would go to the house of Fatima alayha afdalu salatu wasalam. Every morning, before he would stand up for night prayers, he would stand by the door of Fatima alayha afdalu salatu wasalam. He would show her respect. He would show people that she was his main concern.
Mm-hmm.
And as the hadith says, he would tell people that she's his main concern. He says, إِنَّمَا فَاطِمَ بِضْعَةٌ مِنِّي فَمَنْ أَغْضَبَهَا فَقَدْ أَغْضَبَنِي. Now, if you love someone, you tell people, you're public about it. I love this person. You know, he's the closest person to my heart. If he becomes upset, I become upset. Rasulullah did not say this, you know, to only his daughter, or else we would not have these hadith. So Rasulullah used to sit on the minbar before all his companions, all the Muslims, and he would address them. Fatima is the most beloved to my heart. None of you, you know, all of you, you're my companions, my wives, there is respect for them,
mm-hmm.
but the most beloved to me and the dearest person to me is Fatima alayha afdalu salati wassalam. Mm-hmm. In the book of Tirmidhi, the chapter of Akhbar Fatima, the hadiths regarding Fatima alayha afdal as-salati wa salam, the hadith says, إِنَّ جَمِيعًا التَّيْمِي قَالْ دَخَلْتُ مَعَ عَمَّتِي عَلَىٰ عَائِشَةً. This person, Jami' al-Taymi, says, his and his aunt, his father's sister,
mm-hmm.
we entered the house of Aisha, or where she was, I don't know where she was, but they entered and they sat next to her.
Yeah.
He says, فَقَالَتْ لَهَا عَمَّتِي. My aunt told her, oh Aisha, مَا حَمَلَكِ عَلَى الْخُرُوجِ عَلَى عَلِي بْنَ أَبِي طَالِبٍ. What made you go and fight the battle of Jamal against Ali ibn Abi Talib? فَقَالَتْ عَائِشَ دَعِينَا. Leave us for these things. You know, this is political. Don't ask me about this. Leave us about this, off this topic. فَوَاللَّهْ مَا كَانَ أَحَدْ مِنَ الرَّجَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ مِنْ عَلِيٍّ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. Leave this topic, but by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was no man more beloved to the heart of Rasulullah than Ali ibn Abi Talib.
Wow.
وَلَا مِنَ النِّسَاءَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ فَاطِمَةِ سَلَامُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا. So there was, Rasulullah made it clear, even his wife Aisha knows that he loves his daughter more than her. And we see this sometimes within family feuds. You see this, a person remarries or gets married or has a divorce, he forgets his daughter.
Yeah.
Now this new woman in his life is everything.
Yeah.
That was not the case with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He married 9 times. Even though he lived with 9 wives, the most beloved to his heart, the most beloved and precious woman in his life was his daughter Fatima. Oh Muslims, you should read your books. Who's more beloved to the heart of Rasulullah?
Yeah.
Follow her footsteps. She is the true mother of believers.
Mm-hmm. If you'd like, we'll continue this after the break. Just to mention something very quick, is that even after she got married, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam still showed her the support.
He never stopped going to her home. He never stopped showing his love and affection. These hadiths weren't just when she was a child.
Yeah.
These hadiths continued until she got married and she had children.
Yeah, yes. And we'll touch upon that, how that's relevant to today, if it exists or doesn't exist. But after the break, so respected viewers, do stay tuned for after the break for inshallah continue our discussion.
صاحب العصر والزمان بولادة سيدة نساء العالمين أم الحسن والحسين فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام.
Hier aus Deutschland, aus Mannheim, gratulieren wir jetzt unserem Imam al-Mahdi zur Geburt von Sayed Nisa' al-Alamin, Sayed al-Zahra.
We'd like to congratulate the whole Islamic Ummah and Imam of our time on the birth anniversary of our mother Fatima Zahra. Peace and blessings be upon her.
بلادات دي بيدو على حضرت فاطمة الزهراء سلام الله عليها محضرة صاحب العصر والزمان تبارك
مبارك لصاحب الزمان عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف ولادة جدته فاطمة الزهراء سلام الله عليها.
Gratuliere Imam Mahdi aus Mannheim zur Geburt von Sayyida Fatima und ich hoffe, dass bald rauskommt und uns das Grab von Sayyida Fatima zeigt, weil wir sie bald besuchen wollen.
I would like to congratulate our Imam Mahdi عجل الله فرجه on his birthday of his grandmother Fatima الزهراء عليه السلام.
بلادات فاطمة الزهراء سلام الله عليها بإمام الزمان تبارك عز وجل.
نرفع إلى مقام صاحب العصر والزمان أسمى آيات التبليغ والتهاني بميلاد أمه الزهراء عليه السلام. نسأل الله العلي القدير أن نحتفي بهذه المناسبة في الأعوام القادمة ونحن في حضرته.
Ich gratuliere unserem Imam, Imam Sahib al-Zaman, Ajallahu ta'ala, Farajah al-Sharif, zu dem Geburtstag seiner Mutter Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra, Salam
al-Zahra. Imam Zaman to the birthday from my mother Fatima al-Zahra. Salam Allah alayha.
I'm very happy that my father's birthday is from Fatima al-Zahra. Salam Allah alayha. I'm very happy that Imam Zaman, Salam Allah alayha.
نهني صاحب العصر والزمان عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف بولادة سيدة نساء العالمين السيدة فاطمة الزهراء.
Ich möchte unserem letzten Imam zum Geburtstag von Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam zum Geburtstag gratulieren.
نهني صاحب العصر والزمان بولادة النور أم الحسن والحسين السيدة الزهراء عليه السلام.
Ein Congratulation to the birthday of the Bibi Fatima al-Zahra salam Allah alayha.
مبارك لصاحب العصر والزمان ولادة سيدتي مولاتي فاطمة الزهراء.
Ich gratuliere صاحب الزمان zum Geburtstag Fatima الزهراء عليه السلام. Auf Hannover Deutschland.
نهنئ صاحب العصر والزمان بولادة السيدة الزهراء عليه السلام.
Gratulieren wir الإمام الحجة عليه السلام وعجل الله فرجه الشريف zum Geburtstag von der Sayyida Zahra عليه السلام. Und beten Gott, dass er seinen Licht in unsere Welt bald erscheinen lässt.
نبارك لصاحب العصر والزمان بولادة جدته فاطمة عليه السلام.
تالي سلام الله بسم الله بسم الله تالي سلام الله من هالأصالة واطهر سلالة من هالأصالة واطهر سلالة.
Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, once again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I would like to congratulate you once again for the birth of Lady Fatima Al-Zahra. Peace and blessings be upon her. Now, before the break, we did touch upon the importance that a father plays his role within the life of his daughter. This was discussed with my dear guest, Sayed Mudhafar Al-Qazwini. Welcome back, Hayu Sayyidina. Allah Assalamu. Now, before the break, we touched upon a few aspects, and we left off at the idea where even after she got married, Fatima Zahra alayhi salam, you still saw the father involvement within the life of his daughter. Recently, when a daughter gets married off to someone, the father just pulls his hand away from her support.
Or if he divorces his first wife, or she passes away.
She passes away, then you find that, you know, the support isn't there anymore. Now, how did the Prophet react to the loss of his wife, Khadija? And did this affect his relationship, his involvement, his influence to his daughter, Fatima Zahra alayhi salam? Because recently, when, you know, if a wife passes away or gets divorced, the child, the daughter, is the victim. She grows up with social problems, with mental problems sometimes, due to the arguments that happen around. How did Rasulullah face this?
Yes, well, when the mother of believers, Khadija, passed away, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi still lived in Mecca.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't get married through the years that he was in Mecca for maybe a full year, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that year, the year of sorrow, the year that Abu Talib, peace be upon him, and Khadija, alayha afdal as-salatu was-salam, passed away, that you no longer have supporters here, so leave the city of Mecca. But it was just him and his daughter. He lived just with Fatima, alayha afdal as-salatu was-salam. And that day, she became Ummu Abiha. He told her, look, Fatima, even though you're 6 years old, you're my mother, you're my caretaker. Imagine a father tells his daughter such things, how much it changes her.
Definitely.
And the way she thinks. She starts to think at a young age that I have to take care of my father.
Yeah.
And we see the hadiths, and all historians agree that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi was praying, they would go and take the insides and intestines of the sheep and the cows, and they would dump them on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And there was no one there to protect Rasulullah and remove those from Rasulullah. The hadith says that Fatima, peace be upon her, at that young age, she would go remove them off her father, kiss him, remove the blood off the forehead of her father, and she would be his caretaker. She would take care of her father, take care of his wounds.
Wow.
And so did Rasulullah, peace be upon him, take care of her broken heart over her mother. That's why he didn't rush into marrying the next day, because he knew that would break the heart of his daughter.
Definitely.
And the first wives that he chose when he went to Medina were of his best wives, like Umm Salama, that took care of Rasul, actually took care of our Prophet, peace be upon him, and she actually showed love and affection for his daughter and his household, unlike the other wives of the Prophet,
mm-hmm.
Without mentioning names.
Now, specific for daughters and father relationship, currently we find many issues that occur within a household. For example, you mentioned a few. But for example, if we want to bring just one example, we see that recently daughters are going through some phases where they face so many problems because of the fear that the fathers place within the hearts of their daughters. How does Rasulullah, through his involvement with Fatima Zahra alayhi salam, give us the solution to that?
Well, as you mentioned today, like if we see most women that become successful in politics, like presidents or prime ministers, they're probably, most of the time, read in a study, that they were the only child. They never had brothers, so the father showed them all the affection and gave her all the strength she needs. So she reached that position of becoming a president or a prime minister. Female athletes that become, you know, world known, they didn't have brothers, and their fathers gave all they could to their daughters. You know, as we saw in the Olympics, one gymnast, a female gymnast, could earn, you know, over 15 medals, more than what men are earning in the Olympics. And that's because of the support her father gave her. As fathers, the main your mission should be that your daughter's first love shouldn't be someone else. Your daughter's first love shouldn't be Justin Bieber. Your daughter's first love shouldn't be, you know, I don't know who. Your daughter's first love should be you as her father.
Yeah.
You should be that strength that she needs, that shadow that she needs, that protection that she earns for. You have to be her first love and her absolute love. Even when she gets married, because of the love and affection you showed her, your love should stay superior.
Definitely.
Because no one will take care of your daughter better than you.
Yeah.
No man will treat your daughter better than you as a father. Mm-hmm. So if you mistreat your daughter, she'll be mistreated. If you don't show her love, the first person that comes in, you know, says something nice to her, she's gonna grab onto that and think that's love. The first, that's why you see in studies today, girls that are very close to their fathers and their fathers show them love and affection, they usually do not, you know, fall in premature relationships.
Yeah.
They don't have, they don't become pregnant at an early age. Girls that finish their education and they have a real relationship and a positive marriage usually had a very good relationship with their fathers. And those who did not usually end up in divorce and a horrible relationship with every single man they meet and encounter in their life because they did not know how to live with the first man that was in their life.
Mm-hmm.
He did not show them how to live. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi showed Fatima his love and affection.
Mm-hmm.
The hadith and the seerah says that one day Fatima, peace be upon her, became ill. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa alayhi made a gift basket. How many fathers do you know that, you know, send gift baskets to their daughters when they're not feeling well? He went and bought raisins. He went and bought biscuits. You know,
stuff that a child likes.
Not just a child likes, but there was a, you know, 1400 years ago.
Yeah.
You know, don't imagine a Snickers bar or a Doritos. Twix bar, you know, or Doritos. So he went and got what he could get his hand on. Yeah. Sweets, raisins, grapes, honey.
Something healthy.
Something healthy, something to give her energy back. Yeah. And he went and sat next to his daughter and he started feeding her. He starts feeding her and he tells her, this is actually not in her childhood. She's married. She's a married woman.
Oh, wow.
And he's kissing her, kissing his daughter. He's kissing her children. And when it comes to kissing, Rasulullah says, and what the hadith mentions, that every time you kiss your child, your son or daughter, Allah grants you a house in paradise.
Wow.
So Rasulullah used to kiss his daughter Fatima alayha afdal as-salatu wa-salam every day. Every day he would go visit her, kiss her forehead, kiss her chest, kiss her hand.
To that extent.
To that extent. Stand up for her, show her respect. He would stand up, kiss her hand, tell her to sit in his chair.
Wow.
In his position, and then he would sit next to her, smiling in her face, you know, having a pleasant time with her. This is why she was so in love with her father. This is why when he passed, she couldn't stop crying. She couldn't stop shedding tears, because he was the greatest father that a girl could have.
Wow.
So he showed her her love and affection. That's what you need to show. This is your duty as a father. As a father to a son, maybe you need to show him strength. You need to tell him to start doing push-ups when he's, you know, 9, 10.
Yeah.
Show him that strength. Teach him how to, you know, go sell something, buy something, put him in the shop. Teach him how commerce is made. As your job, as a father of
a
girl,
to raise a man.
When you're raising a queen, you need to show her love and affection. And if you don't, this is a lot of parents, you know, in our communities. They wonder why their girls, you know, start speaking to boys at an early age. Or why did this happen? Why did that happen? It's because you were never there.
Yeah.
You as a father, you're never there.
Mm-hmm.
Show people that she means the most to you.
Mm-hmm.
And that will show her what you mean, what she means to you. You know, Rasulullah would sit and tell the people, Fatima bid'atun minni, man sarraha faqad sarrani, wa man sa'aha faqad sa'ani, Fatima a'azzul bariyatu alayhi. He's not, you know, sitting at home saying this, he's telling the people. And of course, the news reaches Fatima, peace be upon her, that today your father, before all the Muslims, after the prayer, he says, Fatima is a part of me. What makes her happy, what makes her smile, makes me smile. And what upsets her, upsets me. Fatima is the most important person out of all the creations of Allah to me.
Wow.
How many of us speak to our daughters this way?
Unfortunately, let's be, you know, optimistic. And give the benefit of the doubt.
Inshallah, this is what we want. We want, you know, better parenting. A father figure is not only there in the life of his son, but should always be there in the life of his daughter as well, you know.
Of course.
We have boys and girls in our families. We have sons and daughters in our families. Our main concern shouldn't be that, you know, he's my son, he's my bloodline.
Wow.
You know, he's the heir. No, your daughter is also. Today was, you know, I made a birthday cake for my son. Today he turned 3.
Oh, mashallah.
So the person making the cake said, what should I write on it? And of course, my daughters are older. They're almost turning 7.
Oh, mashallah.
So I wrote, happy birthday, Fatima, Zahra, and Yusuf, because they could read. He can't even read.
Wow.
So you don't want to break their hearts. You know, their hearts are fragile. And if you break them, it's very hard to bring it back together. It's hard to
especially
bring it
among
back
children,
together.
Small children.
Yes.
They tend to be more jealous of one another. Yeah. Why is their name? But recent studies show that the affection, as you mentioned, that you show to your daughter has the most effect on them. And for example, I mean, a recent study done in 2014 specifically states that attaching and being involved in a daughter's life makes the whole family happy. Because in return, the girl has so much energy and so much to offer within a family that her father either shows her the affection or she's going to show the affection to someone else, as you mentioned. So they said that the solution is to attach yourself to your daughter. Make her feel that she is all that you have. How can we learn to do that? Because currently, and you know, for a person that lived in the West, yes, daughters are spoiled, daughters get everything they want, but is this a solution?
Well, as we mentioned,
because Prophet Muhammad did say, he kind of spoiled her. He says, whatever makes her happy, makes me happy.
Yes, he did. Of course, he didn't spoil her to a point that, it corrupted
made her reckless.
Or made her reckless. In a tradition that after one of the battles, Amir al-Mu'mineen was given loot, spoils of war. From those spoils of war was a cloth. And a silver pendant or bracelet.
A bracelet, yeah.
So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi goes to the house of Fatima as usual. He says he sees there is a cloth by the door. That used to not be there. So he goes, he sees his daughter, she's wearing a bracelet. And he becomes upset. He doesn't say anything. He doesn't shout. He doesn't, raise his hand. He just gets up and he says, goodbye. I'm going to go to my prayer. Which was not of his
usual
self, Usually he'll kiss her. He'll sit and talk with her, eat with her. So Fatima alayha afdhalus salatu wassalam started to feel guilty. What did I do? And she realized. So she took off the bracelet and she took down that cloth and she sent those with the masters of paradise, al-imamain, al-hasan, wal-husayn. She said, go give this to your grandfather. I don't want it anymore. The happiness of my father, the smile of my father, the joy of my father, the respect and honor of my father means much more to me.
What's wrong with this? I mean, why did the Prophet get mad when shouldn't he be happy that his daughter's wearing jewels and having a nice cloth on the wall?
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and as a messenger to mankind, and the household of Rasulullah as teachers to mankind.
Mm-hmm.
Mankind has rich, poor, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So he has to live the life of the lowest ranks. Doesn't mean they were poor. They weren't poor, but they still had to live this life. So even the poorest person in the city could say, okay, I could believe in this guy. He's reachable. He's tangible. I could go sit and talk to him. His daughter, I could go and talk to her as a poor lady. But if she was wearing, the most lavish of clothing,
flashy jewels,
automatically there is a barrier.
Definitely.
The poor feel, oh, maybe she won't talk to me.
Of course.
Maybe he won't, maybe he would ignore me. So that was the reason. But Ahlul Bayt were not poor. Amir al-Mu'mineen, alayhi salam, freed 1,000 slaves from his wealth. He used to own wells. 6,000 golden dinars used to be what the land of Fadak used to give Amir al-Mu'mineen Fatima alayha salatu wasalam. They used to spend on the Muslims. So they were not poor. But they lived as an example of the weakest person and the poorest person in the community. So this is how he disciplined her. And through that discipline, you get outcomes of a lady who becomes Ummu Abiha.
Wow.
The outcomes are the love and the respect and Sayyidati Nisa'il Alameen. She becomes the queen and the mistress of all women in this world and in the hereafter in all worlds.
Salamullahi alayha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to learn as much as we can from her life, because as a daughter to Prophet Muhammad, she teaches us as fathers how to be you know, a good father to your daughter.
Yes.
And, you know, for the daughters and for the sisters, it really teaches, Fatima Zahra teaches you how to become a good daughter to your parents and a good wife to your husband. I would like to thank you very much for joining us tonight. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Fatima Zahra give you the ability to continue serving Ahl Bayt alayhim salam. Respected viewers, do stay tuned for the upcoming episode, inshallah, for we will continue our discussion revolving around Fatima Zahra and her auspicious occasion. Once again, thank you very much. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.